my guns go boom boom and yo guns go. I got the wild style, always been a foul child. My guns go boom boom and yo guns go. I got the wild style, always been a foul child. My guns go boom boom.
What's up?
And yo
this
guns
is Datsik.
Go.
You're tuning in with DJ Tech Tools.
Yeah.
I actually write beats in Logic. I feel like the layout of Logic is much more, sexy. Ableton is definitely more intuitive, and like, you know, you can do more with Ableton. I think eventually I'm gonna switch over, but like it's kind of a little bit of a learning curve to get the mix downs sounding the same way as they do in Logic, because Ableton's a little bit weird like that. I use pretty much all the stock Logic EQs. I love them. I think they sound great. A lot of the Fab Filter plugins. I also use a lot of Effectrix. I use Ring Mods and Camel Fat is like a go-to. I put it on pretty much everything that has to do with bass. I just basically do a bunch of different things with a bunch of different plugins to further amplify that kind of. So if it's like, if my initial sound is like rub, I'll then throw some sort of filter over it to make it kind of go rub, like, and then I'll throw like another thing to kind of just further make it go rub, you know what I mean? And just like, just little bit by little bit, resampling it. I use Massive a lot, and I use the Performer a lot. The Performer is like genius. If I run out of ideas, I'll just hit randomize, maximize all the values, and then just bounce out whatever I have over like an 8-bar period. And then you get some really interesting things. And then you take the parts that sound the coolest, you sample it, and then you start arranging. And then once you arrange it, then you throw the effects over top of it.
Drop it.
I think a lot of that, for like new producers and stuff, a lot of people like to leave their stuff in MIDI, but I think like in order to get a certain type of sound, you just have to keep resampling and, you know, getting it to where you want it. I'm always like, balanced audio, man. You gotta just make that commitment and like just move forward. You know, you end up getting in a rut if you just like are so into changing the same thing over and over and over if you're not happy with it. I basically have the DJM 900 MIDI mapped in Ableton. So I just hit the two buttons on, and then I remap the effects so I can use my own effects out of Ableton directly off the mixer, which is kind of cool. And then I use a Launchpad, and yeah, it's great. I mean, my setup is literally two USB cables. I remapped the mic, the low end of the mic, the EQ. I remapped that to tempo so I can switch tempo with that. And then I got all my other custom effects on the mixer with like just the color knob and everything else. I think dubstep is going through an interesting phase right now. Right now, you know, obviously what's popular is like the crazy squelchy, squeaky high stuff mixed with the crazy, you know, deep, heavy trump wobbles. It's kind of hard to tell where it's going to go from here. I feel like something drastic needs to kind of change, and or something drastic needs to happen. And you know, I feel like the best way to do that is kind of just by exploring different tempos. And you know, obviously 110 is kind of the new thing that's popped up. It's like it's good actually. It's a perfect balance, you know. It's not for the kids that go there to see dubs or hear dubstep, you know, it's not too housey to the point where they're kind of like, this is housey, you know. It's kind of like in between. It's like a wonky kind of electro with more of a hip hop twist on it. And like, that's personally, I actually am having more fun making 110 and playing 110 than I'm even dubstep. So it's like, it's cool. I'm like, I'm totally like kind of trying to spread my wings and just flex my production capabilities in terms of different tempos, you know.